Hi everyone, this is Lahiri from ABCs of Anesthesia, and in this video, we're going to go through a really niche topic that not many people would really think about that often, but it's how to optimize your flashback in your cannula. So I want to thank Brenton Edwards for this comment, which really requested this, so I put it at the top of my priority list, and here we go, I'm going to start making this video. So the first question is, why would you want to even put saline in your cannula chamber? So right now, here we have the chamber of the cannula right there, and we're gonna fill that with saline, and that's gonna speed up the process of flashback, and I'll tell you why that's really important. So the way we do that is essentially take that little cap off and then put some of this solution into there, and I'll show you that as we get into a bit more detail. So the first thing I want to tell you is flashback is absolutely vital. It's the only indication that you have, without other fancy techniques like ultrasound, it's the only indication that your needle and cannula is actually in the vein. So what I mean by that is you've got your needle, and let's imagine that this syringe is a vein. Let's say you go through the skin, and then, you know, you're not getting any blood in this chamber until you actually enter into the vein itself. So once you're in the vein, then you know that your needle's in the vein, and that's why you have to lower the angle and then advance it down before pushing off the cannula. So flashback is vital. It's the first indication, the only indication, that your needle is actually inside the vein. So the only reason we get flashback is, besides the needle being in the vein, the venous pressure is higher than atmospheric pressure. So there's a push of liquid from the high pressure area to the low pressure area, which is in that chamber. So for example, if I was to just get a normal 22 gauge cannula, like so. So what I've done to demonstrate this, I've got a bag of CSL, combined sodium lactate. I've just put some red food coloring in it, so it's not blood. And what I'm gonna do is pretend that that's a vein. So I'm gonna access it through this port here so that I don't have to access an actual vein. And then we'll see what happens. Now, first of all, the pressure in this bag is actually not very high. There's not much, you know, there's a lot of laxity in that. So if I was to use this 22 gauge needle and just put it through this artificial vein, you'll see that there's actually no flashback occurring. And it's only through the increase of pressure. So let's say this is going to be an increase in pressure. Now you get that flashback occurring. So you need some kind of venous pressure for flashback to even occur. So that's the first thing. Now usually flashback is instant. So everything we're talking about putting saline in the chamber doesn't usually matter because there's a vein with high enough venous pressure and you've got a needle that's got a large enough metal tube and chamber there. So even a 22 gauge in a high pressure vein, it's not a problem at all. But if the vein is a very low pressure vein or very small spindly vein, fragile vein, that's when you're gonna have problems and that's when your flashback is gonna be incredibly, incredibly slow. So the main situations that you have very, very low pressure veins are just the small veins. So these are neonates, pediatric veins, and as well as those really tiny veins you might see in elderly patients, but even on your wrist, for example. If you take any small vein on like your feet or your wrist, these small veins anywhere are very low pressure and the flashback will take a lot of time to occur. So now in this scenario of having a very small needle, so there's a very small needle and chamber in a very low pressure small vein, the problem is that your flashback is not going to be quick enough. So imagine that scenario. Let's imagine that this is actually a 24 or 22 gauge needle, and this is a very, very tiny vein. Imagine that you go into the vein, but because it's so small and there's so low pressure, the flashback doesn't traverse up this fast enough, and you just keep going through. So you go through the other side, and then you might see the flashback. So that means that you're already through the other side. Now, there's obviously a solution to this. You just need to go really, really slowly in the smallest, most fragile veins using the smallest cannulas. If you go really quickly, you don't get flashback and you have a problem, your veins, your needle's already on the other side of the vein. But if you go really, really slowly, take your time, then you get flashback and then you know that's time to flatten out and advance. Now, besides going slowly, a method that's been passed down from my supervisor and my seniors to myself and the thing I passed down to my juniors is to put saline in that chamber of the cannula, and that will speed up flashback. The reason for this is now instead of having fluid in the vein, so blood, and air in your chamber, so now you need an actual pressure differential, what happens is when you put liquid like saline, it means that you get a flashback not just through a pressure gradient, but also through diffusion. And I'll show you what I mean with this demonstration. In this first scenario, I've got a 22 gauge needle, and I've got no saline in the chamber, it's just air, it's just as it comes normally. Now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna imitate puncturing through the vein, and let's just see how quickly it happens. So puncturing the vein, now it's through there now, and then you'll see that a flashback has occurred in the chamber right there. So that's the first scenario. So in the second one, I take my cannula, I uncap it as normal. I then take off this little device here, so that just comes off like that. Make sure that's all clean and sterile. Obviously I'm not doing aseptic non-touch technique for this demonstration. I take a syringe of saline and I simply put saline into that chamber until it drips out the other side, as you can see. So now that whole needle column is filled with saline. I remove my syringe and then I recap it in a clean fashion. So now I've got a cannula, nothing's changed except the fact that I've now got a saline fluid column throughout the whole needle and into the chamber. So as I enter the vein, you'll see a different quality to the flashback. As you can see, it kind of squirts out the other side. So that's the reason why I use saline in the chamber in the smallest, most difficult veins, especially pediatrics, neonates, and just adults with really difficult veins. So I go slowly, really, really slowly, waiting for that flashback to occur, but I also use saline in the chamber to get a quicker flashback to make sure that I don't go through the other side. So that's the reason I use saline in the most difficult veins. So I hope you enjoyed this video. That's a really simple technique that I use for the most difficult cannulas. Please write any comments, any feedback, or any other techniques that you might have for the most difficult cannulas. So please write in the comments below. And yeah, I'll see you next time for the next video. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.